Of the Ladies' Room, Anne Harrell, founder of the Boston Young Professionals Association, gives us the scoop on networking in Boston. And now, our four fresh new hosts.
Hello, and welcome to the Ladies' Room. Our focus for this episode is the concept of a fresh start. Summer has gone and the school year has started, creating the perfect opportunity for change. Even the cast of Ladies' Room has been revamped, literally. I'm Francesca. We want you to get us to know us a little bit better, so we're going to talk about what our major is, what our minors are, what year we are, and also, to spice things up a little bit, we're going to share our worst pet peeve with you. So, I'll start. My name is Francesca. I'm a marketing junior with a minor in psychology, and my worst pet peeve is people who don't know how to walk on the sidewalk. Sometimes they walk in rows of four, arms linked. Other times they walk at probably 2 miles an hour. And regardless, I hate them. This is Amelia.
I'm from Seattle. My major is film and WLP. And my biggest pet peeve would have to be passive aggressiveness, because I'm very combative. So when people are passive aggressive, I don't really know what to talk to them about.
All right. This is Kim.
Hi, I'm Kim. I'm a freshman and I'm a broadcast journalism major. I have to say my pet peeve is when people are cheap. Like, you go to a restaurant, they're like, oh, I ate before I came, I'm just gonna sit here. And then they like pick off your plate. It's like, dude, get your own food. You know, and then they like mysteriously leave before the bill comes. Like, so that's my pet peeve when people are cheap. So.
Well said. Mm-hmm. And our last lady is Miss Katie.
I am a broadcast journalism major with minors in history and communication disorders, and I'm a junior. And I have I have a couple pet peeves, but I have two that are tied. One is cigarette smoking, no explanation needed. Moving on to the second one, which is probably more important, which is people that have no idea about fashion. And I'm not talking about trends or style or anything, just people that wouldn't look good if you put them in any era. Aww. And they think that they do. So yes, we have to feel bad and nurture them, but we need to show them the light. So, a nation stands divided, family and friends arguing over dinner, t-shirts bearing slogans that are actually relevant for once. These all point to the one touchy subject, election 2004. Some are dreaming of a new era, while others are hoping for the legacy to continue. Others just like to protest, regardless of their motives. Celebrities, fashion designers, and our generation in particular are stepping up and pledging to vote. So are you ladies gonna vote?
Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah. I think that you don't really have a right to discuss politics if you don't vote.
I mean, it's not, I think a lot of people think of it as like something that they have to do, or it's like a chore, but it's like one thing that you can like get out there and do and like show what you really stand for. So why not? It's just like extending your voice.
Right. Exactly.
So how do you feel about celebrities getting involved, particularly Marc Jacobs and P. Diddy?
I don't think they should be criticized. I know Ben Affleck has got some flack recently for being hardcore Carrie. And the sad truth is, many Americans do take what celebrities say seriously. Mm-hmm. And so if they're using their names for a good cause, in this case politics, then I'm all for it.
Exactly. I think if it's going to make a difference, then I mean they're willing. They can do
whatever
they
want. I mean, I
think
it's fine, but. I mean, at one point, it's awesome what they're using their name for, but on the other point, it's like, who are they? You know, why do they get to like stand up and like talk about it more than we do? You know, and it's like someone like near you might not be in the spotlight, but they get to like, but like their voice will never be heard. But someone like Ben Affleck, like, does he really know what he's talking about? But his voice is always heard. So I think it's like good that they can like really say what they think because of their name, but at the same time, it's like.
But they have the fame. I mean, if they're going to have the fame, they might as well use it.
Yeah, there's a lot of them available. So.
Yeah.
Even if they say something stupid, at least it gets people thinking about it.
Right. Yeah, and I've noticed that a lot of the celebrities aren't talking so much about they bring up their political affiliation, but it's more just the fact to get people to vote.
Yeah, right. That's true. They're just saying, regardless of parties, you just need to get out there and say what you think.
Yeah. No, definitely.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So, did you guys watch the debate last night?
I didn't get a chance to watch the debate.
I saw it. I don't really know what I thought. I felt like, I don't know if I should say this, but I lean more towards liberal. And I felt like I was really disappointed with both sides.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought that, even though, you can pick a side, but you really have to be open and, listen to both people. And I think a lot of people went into it, set on something. Right. And that they should, just go into it with more of an open mind. Okay. And if you're interested in voting, but you haven't registered yet, go to rockthevote.com. And if this election is anything like the last one, there's going to be much more treachery and drama than any reality TV show. It's kind of like Real Life Survivor. I thought reality TV was going to be a flash in the pan, and it's still around. Have you ladies noticed any new TV trends for this year?
I have to say animation.
Yeah. Animation?
Cartoons.
Yeah.
Movies and TV shows.
Yeah. You guys heard that new TV show, Father of the Pride?
No.
Yeah, they've been pitching it for a while.
Is it out
I really
yet,
I didn't hear it about
come,
it.
Like what?
All right, so I guess it's a new show, and it's a cartoon, it's animated, but it has a lot of adult humor in it. Mm-hmm. And it's in prime time. So it's going to take the place of Friends, kind of. It's on NBC.
What is it about? Is it political commentary? What is it?
I think it's I guess I heard the last show had a lot of sexual innuendo in it, which is weird. You know, it's lions. What are they?
Yeah, it's not people.
I don't really got a male. But I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you think that they're going to animation now because for a while we had actors and then we have reality TV, and now it's people are getting over reality TV, so they have to go to animation.
They have to find something new, absolutely. Yeah. I'm actually surprised that it's taken so long for them to turn to animation, because, gosh, what was it, 2000? Probably 2001, A Bug's Life, right. Ants, Shrek.
Yeah.
They all sort of came out, and it was this big, crazy thing, but everyone seemed to love it.
Yeah.
And so I would have thought that they would pounce on that right away, but it's taken a couple years, but I think it's a surefire thing.
Yeah. I think it's cool that people are saying, it's because people, they need something else to go to, but it's good script and it's good commentary, so why not?
And I think also from a production aspect of it, I would guess that animation is cheaper to make than using actors.
Well, nothing's as cheap as reality TV, probably.
That's true.
But you can only morally see enough reality TV, I hope. Yeah. I hope it comes to an end eventually.
Yeah. I don't know. But I like some of the reality television that's out there.
What do you
it's
watch?
It's a secret vice. Well, I just started watching, have you guys heard of Laguna Beach? It just
is
opened.
That really reality, though, or is it actors?
No, of course it's reality.
What is
they're just
Beach?
Really hot, so they look like
it's
actors.
It's a show on MTV. And it looks like reality TV, but it's actor.
Okay, no, it follows this group of kids on their last year of high school. They're all seniors, and they come from a really affluent community. They're dubbing it the new
OC. And they
OC.
All fall in love with each other.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. How do you guys feel about Joey, the spinoff of Friends?
I haven't seen it.
I hated Joey anyway, but they kind of picked the biggest loser.
I just hated how they always were hooking up with each other.
But Francesca, speaking of love,
I feel like my love life in Boston is more Will and Grace than, would ever be considered normal or ideal. For those of you who are in a relationship that seem to be going nowhere, fall is a natural transition to break those ties to your summer fling and find something more suitable to your tastes. The only problem is that even if you're ready to rock, it can be hard to find somebody to roll with. Do you girls have any suggestions for finding autumn romance?
Nope.
Yes. Of course, I have suggestions.
I think we need to be pickier, just as people, because we date these people, and I'm doing this right now, where I pick out all these flaws and stuff. Well, I just feel that we should start with a person that we're completely happy with and content with, and that we don't want to change.
Is there such a person?
Yeah.
You know what always happens to me? I always like someone, and then I can flirt with guys if I don't like them, but if I like them, I can't even talk to them. And I freeze up.
Well, you get nervous.
Yeah.
Of course. That's normal.
But I like this guy in the LB.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, and he doesn't know that I like him. And then
shout out.
Yeah.
Whatever. Let's just stop right now.
I am so impressed that you found a guy in the LB to like, because personally, when I was living there, what a drought. Emerson, it may be stimulating for the mind, but I didn't find it very stimulating romantically, I have to say. You have to find outside sources.
That's true. Yes.
And you also have to go to yourself. Speaking of which, regardless of what you do or where you go to meet someone new, the old saying is still true. Before you can love someone else, you must first love yourself. Fall is a great time to break bad habits and start some good ones. Are there any personal plans or improvements that you ladies are going to make this fall?
Well, I'm just going to get
4.0 at school. What about you guys?
That's what I say every year. Yeah. I treat the beginning of the school year like a different sort of New Year's. Yeah. I make resolutions. Do you guys do that?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Well, not so much resolutions, but every season I change my hair drastically.
Really?
Yeah.
What about your style?
About 3 months ago, okay, at the end of last semester, it was bright red and a mohawk.
So I never saw that, really? Was it a faux hawk or like a mohawk?
Mohawk. It's a little bit of both.
Interesting. Mm.
Yeah. Well, anyways, those are all some great ideas, ladies. Join us after the break, where we'll talk to a woman who helps many Boston women taking their first steps towards a fresh start. Stay tuned.
What? Are we rolling anyway, even though you're not there? Always. The camera's always watching me.
Some people like it because it lets them know what mood I'm in, because I have lots of meows. There's like the mad meow, which is meow, and then there's like the meow, which is like you're not paying attention to me kind of thing. And there's the happy meow, meow!
The Emerson Channel, turn us on. 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 On, turn us. Emerson Channel us.
Huh. Well, I'm just really, really sick. Hi, I'm on the Emerson Channel. I'm dying. How about that for a promo?
They say the hardest part of any task is just getting started. I found one woman who has been the helping hand for many women in the Boston area. Let's check it out. If you're interested in helping this... Oh, okay, cool.
Hi, we're here at the Boston Rescue Mission, which is a rehabilitation center for people who are homeless and coming from rehabs. They've been open since 1899, and we're going to go inside and check out people who are getting their fresh start. So come on.
But I think it might be good to hear from a client's perspective who's been here for how long now, Sharon?
I'm 9 months clean today.
And I'm sorry, can you tell us your name again?
I'm 9 months clean today.
They want to know your name.
Oh, my name is Sharon Beach, and I'm a grateful, blessed, recovering addict. And I know that God put me here for a reason. And that was to get the help that I needed, you know, because I felt that, you know, being hopeless, homeless, and drug dependent, you know, those together, I needed help. I wanted to get off the drugs. So God had opened up this door for me. And like I said, I got a spiritual awakening, but I needed a closer relationship with God.
Jenny Festa Braverman.
Lynn Simon.
Can you tell me ways in which students might be able to get involved?
We have a number of groups that come through that do like a one-time helping in the kitchen. They serve, they clean.
The Boston Rescue Mission provides the tools and support necessary to get your fresh start. If you're interested in getting more involved, you can visit the website at www.bmr.org. Or you can contact the ladies' room. Again, I'm Amelia.
If you're interested in helping this cause as well, go to www.brm.org for more information. So basically what happened is I went to Boston Rescue Mission, and I talked to a caseworker, a missionary worker, and a client. And this client was really, really inspirational because she had been living on the streets and addicted to drugs for years and years and years. And this place basically found a way to support her and to help her recover. It made me really like want to get involved. So is there anything that you guys are involved in right now?
I would love to get involved in something right now. I feel so tempted to do something like the Big Sister programs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
When I was in high school, I used to help out at the local library. I taught a class.
Yeah.
My children took notes.
I was a candy striper.
You were?
Uh-huh. You know, kind of like Belle on Days of Our Lives?
Yeah.
Yes. I totally did
or
that.
Kelly and Saved by the Bell. She did it.
Yeah, yeah. But the same, you know, I had the same outfit.
You did?
Uh-huh.
That's awesome.
What was your most exciting task?
We had to wear white kid tennis shoes. I couldn't do it.
Oh my God.
It was a lot of like restocking. Mm-hmm. And so we just had to wear like this little dress and climb up ladders into these stock rooms and like get like packages of gauze and
did
like,
that move you?
Stock it up. It didn't move me that much. And then they would just make me go, like, they would always pick like the most, like, you know, unfriendly, mean old man you'd have to go talk to. And they would always ask me if my teeth were real because they were white.
Oh, really?
And they were still in my mouth. So I'm like, yes, they're real.
Well, that's
they probably weren't used to it.
Coming up next, we're going to find out how to maximize our networking and build some social and professional ties. Stick around.
Always. The camera's always watching me.
Some people like it because it lets them know what mood I'm in, because I have lots of meows. There's like the mad meow, which is meow, and then there's like the meow, which is like you're not paying attention to me kind of thing. And there's the happy meow, meow!
The Emerson Channel, turn us on. 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 On, turn us, Emerson Channelists.
Huh. Well, I'm just really, really sick. Hi, I'm on the Emerson Channel, I'm dying. How about that for a promo?
Hello, I used to live on Beacon Street and I didn't have the Emerson Channel. But since I have moved to 10 Boylston Place, not only do I have the Emerson Channel, I'm in the Emerson Channel. Please watch, you'll learn.
Yet when I say
all work
Emerson
and no play isn't the way to go. With us today is Anne Harrell, the founder of the Boston Young Professionals Association, and she's going to tell us how to make friends and connections all at the same time. Anne, welcome to the show.
Hey, Anne.
Good to have you.
So tell us, what is the Boston Young Professionals Association?
Well, we are a network of, last count, about 7,800 young professionals, grad students, in the Boston and Metro Boston area. We do networking, social events, charity events, volunteering, mm-hmm. you name it. Basically, the point is for young professionals in the area to have a community where they can get together, do things, and meet each other.
Is it at all like a dating service or?
No.
No.
It's a common misconception. We do both singles events and couples events.
Okay.
So we are not a singles organization, but we, as I said, basically, if there's anything a young professional wants to do that's not, you know, X-rated or something like that, we do it, and we, you know, give people a venue
Got it. Now, it says that you're the founder, mm-hmm. and you also said disdainfully that this is not a dating service. So, is that a problem that you ran into before? Anything involving young professionals it seemed like they all wanted to hook up to? Why did you start this specific association?
Why did I start this association? Basically, because I came to Boston. I'm not from here. Mm-hmm. Fell in love with it and saw that there really wasn't a venue for, you know, young professionals to sort of come together. I mean, you have your colleges, and when you're in college, you know, you can meet those people. But if you're brand new to the city, there wasn't anything before we came along for that. And then there isn't really a way to, you know, help people network if you're not, you know, 50 years old.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, even though it's not a dating service, have you noticed like a lot of relationships that start from going to it?
As I said, we do some singles events.
Yeah.
So, you know, there's all kinds of relationships that get formed. I personally have met tons of friends through it, but I noticed that, you know, there are some faces that show up over and over and over again, and they didn't know each other before
cool.
this, and now, you know, they're friends coming to the events together.
Yeah,
there's, you know, business relationships that have been formed. I met at the 1 year anniversary we had in April, a couple came there that said they had met at our first event, and
oh,
this
really?
Was their 1 year anniversary.
Awesome. Oh. Did you get invited to their wedding?
Oh, I don't think it was a 1 year dating anniversary. I don't think they got married.
Okay. We should tell them, be like, wedding.
So it's something that people come back to on
a regular absolutely.
Basis.
We have, as I said, 7,800 members. Approximately 3,500 of them are paid members, so they have like an annual dues that they pay. They get a membership card, free networking events. We do seminars, you know, so people are coming weekly. We have like a weekly networking thing that we do. Mm-hmm. So.
That's cool. And I read on your website you donate some proceeds to charities.
Mm-hmm. We have something called a Charity of the Month program, which mm-hmm. our board of advisors, we have a board of advisors of about 24 extremely wonderful people who get together and help run this thing. And they are in the process right now of revamping that program. But basically what it is we choose a charity and we represent, or they represent, I don't know how to put this, but for 2 months we help support that charity.
Mm-hmm.
So 5% of the proceeds of all the events we do go to that charity during those 2 months, and then we would hold like one 100% charity benefit event for them.
Oh, that's really awesome.
So. Do you do any community service with the charities that you donate to?
Yes, we do, but we also do community service with other charities, not just those. For instance, they are going to help the Ollie Road Race this Sunday, or actually, I guess this is airing after this has already happened. but
hope
people
you all
are
can.
Volunteering at the Ollie Road Race, which is the South Boston Neighborhood House.
Mm-hmm.
They just volunteered for the Greater Boston Food Bank a couple weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
We volunteer for community serving, so, you know, people love to donate their services. And, you know, in their time, and it's a great benefit to a lot of the charities, and they get to meet each other and socialize at the same time, so it's really great.
I was going to ask, what's been like your favorite event that you've thrown? Do you have a favorite?
I have a couple favorites. When is this airing? Do you mind my asking?
It's evergreen. You can say whatever you'd like.
I'm just so funny. My absolute favorite event we're doing on October 16th. And it's a little one. It's not like we have tons of really big events, but it's called Fall Fun in Sterling, Massachusetts. And we go to the Davis Mega Maze, which is like an adult mega maze designed by the best maze people in England.
Wow,
and it like takes
really
like
a labyrinth?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, that's
just
so
like
awesome.
A labyrinth. It takes like 2.5 hours to get through. It's not like
so
some
cool.
little kids
wow.
thing.
Oh,
and
so
then
cool.
we go from there to these farms and go apple picking and pumpkin picking.
Oh,
and
I'll be there.
It's so much fun. I'm sorry, I get so
wait,
I
am I too young?
I'm
too young to go, right?
How old are you?
We're all
19.
Yes,
that's
19
exactly
and 20.
What
I wanted to talk to you about. Your association sounds so great, but not all of our viewers are old enough to mm-hmm. become involved. You
right.
have to be 21, right?
Right.
So do you have any tips or information that you can share with the 18, 19, and 20-year-olds?
unfortunately, I really, I mean, I don't know.
As far as networking goes, you know, we do have a lot of, for example, Kim is a freshman.
Yeah. Right.
Now, Kim is very sociable, but what if there's someone out there that's shy and is having a hard time with networking and just making friends? Do you have any tips?
Well, I would think that your school would have some sort of clubs that you could get involved in. My understanding, I mean, I went to school at Mary Washington College, and they had get-togethers, and then, you know, once you get to be an alumni, they have all those things, too. But, you know, basically, like, when I create an event, I base it on an interest, and it's the same sort of idea, you know, for a club. There's an event, and there's an interest, but within doing that interest, you meet the people who have common interests. And
yeah, it's, like, better that you can go and, like, talk to people, because if you go to, like, a movie with a guy, it's like you just sit there.
Right.
Yeah, right.
And this is cool, because you can
get,
like,
to know people.
Right, so, I mean, if you're in school yet, and you're not 21, not able to join, you know, a professional organization or something, I would just recommend, you know, joining your school's clubs.
Yeah. What made you decide to make it 21 plus? Was there something specific that...
Most of our events are held in bars.
Oh, yeah.
That has one thing to do with it. And then the secondly is that, you know, the jobs. It's for professionals.
For professionals. So
we pretty much, we limit our membership to, we will admit seniors usually in college if you're of that age. But our official tagline is that we admit grad school students and professionals.
All the better for networking.
Yeah. Right.
I liked the idea that you have of events, because one of the biggest complaints from college students, at least, is there's nothing to do.
Yeah.
We're in
yeah.
the city, but no one ever does anything unconventional, like this maze thing. Where do you get these ideas?
Oh, I don't know. I just, I sit there and I think, you know, what would be fun?
What other cool things have you done that someone, I'm interested in?
Well, let's see. We have a scavenger hunt.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
we do, like, mm-hmm. a whole scavenger hunt around the city. You get together, and, like, we had 80 people at the last one, and you get formed in a teams of, like, 6 people, and you get to go from T station to T station to T station in Boston. So you sort of get to tour the city while you're running around trying to find stuff.
Another mm-hmm. fun idea. Well,
that's great.
And thank you for joining us today.
Thank you very much.
You've given us some really great ideas. Go to bostonypa.com for more information. Thank you all for tuning in, and thank you for joining us on our fresh start.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.